a nice piece of cable came with the guitar. They sent a guitar lead, which is no good as a guitar lead, but it's quite good enough to cut and use inside the guitar. And it's a shielded cable, so it's perfect for the job. And the other tools for adjusting the neck and the intonation are also sent with the guitar. So you have everything you need, really, apart from a few other ends to do the guitar. Okay, we need to deal with the end of the cable the same as we did before. And we need to join, first of all, twist the earth part of the cable to the blue wire, which is the earth wire, and then to solder it up. Now we need to chop off from the switch one of the pickups coming in, the pickup that you want to go direct out, you don't want to go to the switch, you want to be on all the time. You just cut this one off, leaving the other one on the switch. And then join that wire, bare the end of it, and join that wire to the live part of the one that you just made the earth wire for. Solder it all up, and that's one pickup done. And mark it somehow so you know which one's which. Deal with the other one the same, this time attaching it to the yellow wire coming from the switch. And this particular one, I haven't actually done anything with the earth, but you may like to solder this earth up later to something. It's not necessary because this is earth at the other end, yet it's always good to have plenty of earth. Okay, what I did was I taped it all up and I used a bit of the old cable wire to push over the ends. What you should really do is use heat shrink, but I can't afford such luxuries, so you just make do with tape is not the best. It will fall off in the end, but by that time I will have changed the wire into something else. Now, as you can see, we've got the wires through the cavity, and we just have to now join these two sets of wires together, best we can. Right, so it's back to the same old procedure. And we want to join the wires, we go in live to live and earth to earth, and there's a few of them there, so be careful as you go and make sure they all line up nicely, and cover the ends the same as you did before, and you should have a nice tidy job when you're finished. All soldered up and nothing touching live to earth, that's the main thing. I managed to push it all underneath the rear pickup and get the pickup down on top of it. All seemed to fit perfectly. And so, I just put everything back together and screw all the screws in. And that part of the wiring is now finished. And we can start to look at, whilst we're here on the bench, we may as well shift over the strap pin from the one side of the guitar to the other. You'll need a 2mm drill bit for this. Just a normal drill bit will do fine, whatever you've got. And just carefully drill the hole in the middle of the other horn. And when you've done that, you can then lubricate the screw before you screw it in. Don't screw it in without lubricating, because you could quite easily split the mahogany. It's very, very, very brittle wood. Use a lubricant and you should be right. Okay, it looks like we're now ready to put everything else back together again. before we do that, I just noticed that whilst I was working on it, a piece of solder by accident fell onto the white plastic of the pick guard. And so I took this as a sign. I don't ever make mistakes like this, except it means something. It's a good thing, actually. And so I could see that I needed to sign the pick guard the same as I've seen other people do whenever you change something and make it your own. So I then proceeded to paint my signature onto the pick guard using just a little bit of gold paint that I had lying around the house. It's good to finish off and fill the hole with a bit of polyfiller. And this is white, and I noticed that the other objects are holes have been filled with a black substance. I don't have any of this, but I can improvise this along the way. And I also decided not to do anything about the dot markers on the edge of the neck at this point. Now's a good time to oil the fingerboard. I normally just use maize oil for this because it's cheap, it's readily available, it's normally in the house, and does a nice job afterwards. You play the guitar, it feels good. So there you go. I don't recommend it to anybody. It works for me. I normally put lots of it on so it can just soak in whilst I'm working on it. And then I clean everything up, clean my hands up, and clean the guitar up at this point in time so everything's nice and tidy for the next part of the job. And that just before I continue, a good time to just paint the white, now it's dry, just to paint the white filler with a little bit of black ink that I have, that I use for my artwork. Pelican Touche A, I think it's called. It's a permanent ink, it works okay. Next thing to do is to put the bridge back on. I think that's the tailpiece back on, sorry. And you can then, once that's all been done, the strap can go on and you can see what you've got in the way of a guitar. You can hang it around your neck and you'll find it's a little bit neck heavy, as the reviews say. There's not a lot we can do about that at this stage. It's not that bad, yet at some time in the future I'm going to make it perfectly balanced, and I'll do another video about how I managed to do that in the easiest way possible. Now, before we put the strings on, I noticed from my other guitars that because I tune down my guitars down to D, for me it's a whole tone down, that the tension in the neck rod is too tight, and so I've had to loosen off the neck a little bit on the other guitar. So I've done this one turn of the hex wrench loose before I put the strings on, and it worked out perfect. Now we start to put the strings on very carefully, very slowly, one pair at a time, working from either end inwards, and just tensioning them as we go a little bit. I set the intonation up on the saddles by hand, just by eye as best I could, just as a starting point, and it turned out to be completely different to where I had set it when I came to adjust it. Alright, we put in the strings on in layers, and the thin strings seem to be going on okay, and the height of the nut seems to be okay for the thin strings. It's just the thicker strings that are sitting a little bit proud. And so what we need to do is cut away into that and make the holes bigger. I don't have any proper tool for that. The best tool I ever found for it was a very, very fine saw. I think it was used for fret saw or something like that. I don't have one of these. All I'd end up using was my knife and a bit of emery paper, and I just didn't do it too deep, that's all, just a very, 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 as little as possible. And I'll probably come back to doing it again on some of the strings before I'm finished. But it's good to just get the strings on, get everything roughly right at this point without going too deep, because you don't want to have to go and find another nut and start from scratch again. Okay. Okay, just the highest string left to do, And this is the what would be the high G string. And if you press on the G note on the high E string, the first string, that's a note that this one is tuned to. And it's necessary to be very, very careful with the tuning, because you can go up an octave too high, and if you're not used to it, and and so be careful with the tuning. Take it slowly, take it easy. There you are. There's your left-handed 12-string guitar, and it's nearly the end of the day, and we're finished. Not fully, yet enough to play it. What I used on the nut, just a knife and a little piece of emery paper. That's all I had, really, but it's worked out all right. And I just played it and finally got it all in tune, and just played it through the amplifier, and wow, it's a big guitar, it's in your face, and so you have to be a much better player play one of these things than what I am, because I just started. This is my first electric 12 string. And so if you watch Roger McQuin play Turn, Turn, Turn on YouTube, you'll see what a master of a 12 string can do. Also Lead Belly, of course, nobody can beat him. He is the absolute master of everything. And so he started it all with a 12 string. And I'm very happy to follow in the footsteps of these great masters. And part of the journey is making your own instrument, or your instrument your own. And so this journey has led me to really fully appreciate how much work is involved by these great Chinese masters at making these instruments, because I can't do it as well as they can, that's for sure. So, the bells are ringing and it's time, it's the end, it's finished. And so I hope there are many other left-handed guitarists who follow this journey so far to the 12 string, because not many people make it to the electric 12 string guitar. Thank you.